In this video, we're going to discuss how to calculate the percent mass composition for each atom in the formula. There are two ways to go about it depending on the question. One is through theoretical calculation, and another is using experimental values. The formula for percent mass is mass of the element divided by the mass of the compound times 100%. Let's use some examples to test out this formula. The first example is using the theoretical calculation. We're given the formula of naphthalactone, which is C10H14O2, and we're asked to find the percent composition for each element. The formula for percent mass is mass of the element divided by mass of the compound times 100. So first of all, let's find the mass of the compound, which in this case is naphthalactone. Basically, we need to find the molar mass of C10H14O2. We'll need to find the atomic mass of each atom and then multiply by the number for each atom. Carbon is 12.01. We times it with 10 since we have C10. And then H is 1.008. So we times that with 14 because we have H14. Then O is 16.00. And we times that with 2 because there's O2. And then we add them all together and we get 166.212 grams per mole. That is the mass of the compound, which is the molar mass of naphthalactone. Since there are three types of atom in the compound, we'll need to find the percent carbon, percent hydrogen, and percent oxygen. Starting with the percent of carbon, we take the mass of the element, which is going to be 10 times 12.01. Since carbon's atomic mass is 12.01, and there are 10 carbon present in the formula, we divide with the mass of compound, which is 166.212 times 100, and we get 72.26%. That's the percent of carbon in the formula. Now we move on to do the same for hydrogen, and we have 14 times 1.008 divide by 166.212, and we get 8.49%. And we repeat the same thing for oxygen. Now we have 2 times 16 divide by 166.212 times 100, and we get 19.25%. Now we can quickly check out our work by adding up all the percentages we have found for carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. These three numbers should add up to 100%. This is the method for calculating the percent composition by mass using theoretical values. Now we move on to another example, which is percent mass by experimental values. Notice how this question is slightly different from the first one. Over here, we are actually given the mass of iron, which is 2.52 grams, and the mass of oxygen, which is 1.08 grams. And then we're asked to find the percent mass of iron and oxygen. So our sample clearly only contains iron and oxygen. So that means using the same formula, we need to figure out the mass of the compound, which we can get by easily adding the mass of iron and oxygen, which gives us 3.60 grams. That's the mass of the compound containing iron and oxygen. To find the percent iron, we take the mass of iron and divide by the mass of compound. And that works out to be 70.0%. And then we do the same thing for percent oxygen, except for now we take the mass of oxygen, which is 1.08, divide by 3.6 times 100, and we get 30%. Again, to double check, we quickly add up the percentages that we've calculated. 70 plus 30, that gives us 100%. With that, we've calculated the percent iron and oxygen using the experimental values. To recap, we've looked at two ways of calculating percent mass composition. One is through theoretical calculation, another is through experimental values. There are other videos related to this topic on empirical and molecular formula, limiting reactant, percent yield, percent purity. I'll place their links in the description box below. Be sure to check them out. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.